I'm sure doctors have cared, but these symptoms can make you even doubt yourself.
All right, we're going to get back to Anna. Yeah. We were having some technical difficulties with her shot, but we have told you about this before, about these so-called COVID long haulers. Those are the people who still have symptoms of the virus months after testing positive.
So finally, it looks like there could be some explanation for those long haulers. A local cardiologist is one of the few clinics in the entire country helping with that treatment. Here's Monica Garcia.
So before COVID, seeing a specialist like this could take up to a year just to get into this office. Now that process is quicker because doctors have finally found a link to a little known disorder.
It's been a year and a half since this once energetic mother, grad student, and emergency room nurse, Tyra Street, hasn't felt sick.
I was so short of breath that I was struggling just to walk.
She's a long hauler, someone who has lingering symptoms months after getting COVID, and her case twice while working the front lines during the height of the pandemic.
It's just kind of been like pinball. It just goes through your body.
Aside from fatigue.
Well, doctors will be like, oh, well, you're overtired.
She suffers from headaches, rapid heartbeat, and brain fog.
Just this week, I left the stove on for 2.5 hours.
Her symptoms so severe, she stopped working.
As I was leaving on an ambulance going to the hospital because my blood pressure was too high again, going, you've got to see Dr. Desai. She does hard. She'll figure out what's going on.
And that's when she learned about a little-known condition, postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome, or POTS, a blood circulation disorder.
What it means is that the nervous system gets attacked and our fight-or-flight response is impaired. So essentially, we have all these symptoms from head to toe.
Cardiologist Dr. Sakaria Desai has treated people with POTS for years, but now COVID long haulers make up more than 50% of her practice at Arizona Heart 360.
We were at least able to diagnose her and get her started and stabilized.
Even in the medical community, she says, there's a lack of awareness of the condition.
That people really need to advocate for themselves and not accept this as it's not that bad, it's not that bad.
Dr. Desai says it's too early to know how many people with lingering COVID symptoms have POTS, but left untreated, symptoms typically get worse.
Currently, Dr. Desai is one of a handful of specialists in the Southwest and West Coast treating people with post-COVID POTS. In Phoenix, Monica Garcia with Arizona's Family.